Alrighty, welcome back. The car's just been painted about probably an hour ago. And basically what's going on is we're scared to peel the tape off after it dries too much. And the basic reason why we're scared to peel it off after it dries too much is because the paint could have bridged onto the tape. And Joni's gonna peel a bit off here and see how it goes. And you're gonna get to watch. And you'll get to swear when paint comes off, just like I will. But Joanie's gonna do it, and I'm just gonna sit here and film her, and we can watch together. The car has a nice sheen to it. It really does. I had a few issues with it. And like as always, we don't want to talk about the issues, but it really does have a nice shine on it. There's no runs in it. Like I always said, dirt is free. But it's not perfect by no means. And I always like to say that because I'm human just like everybody else. I want everybody to realize that, you know, as it looks good on camera, there is, when you walk around, there's places that I'm not satisfied, you know. It's probably a 7 out of 10. Looks good and straight down the side though. What happens is we put, when we put the door skins back on, we put like a weather seal that you put on like on a door or a window. What has one sticky side, and then there's a felt side, it'd be like a sponge rubber side. What I did is I stuck two rows of that on the door. And what happened is it just held that door skin out a little bit better. You look down that door skin, we don't see any big waves or anything. Like I said, something high looks better than something low. How's the paint, Joanie? Is it touch easy? Is it all right to touch? Like it's not coming off your fingers, is it?
A little bit. But...
Okay, so she got a little bit of paint on her fingers here. So we've only painted probably an hour ago, but. What's happening is with this car, we're scared to let it dry completely and have it bridge to the tape, and then we would be ripping off, ripping off paint that is dry onto something that is dry, so we'd be separating the paint from the tape. And that would be a scary proposition where it's a little bit wet like this, a little bit damp. I think it's easier to rip off. And that's why we're here doing it right at the present moment. This red that we put on the car is red that we had in the shop. You know, we're keeping the price down. We're being, what's that called? Practical? Practical. It's a nice looking red. It really is. Now we're just kind of nervous of ripping off the gray because we had the issue with the non-sanding and the plastic car. This is a plastic car. There's always issues with that sort of stuff. How you making out, Joanie?
I'm good.
No issues. No issues so far?
Yeah.
The silver and the gray really look good together, I think. You know, it looks fresh, looks new. I'm one of those guys that's very critical on something like this. You know, if something doesn't look exactly the way I want it to look, I get very critical. You can hear the tape peeling, trying to pull that gray paint off, can't you?
Yeah.
You can hear it trying to pull the gray paint off. We're not wanting it to. and we want to get the red off and separate it at the same time, because I've got red paint on that tape. You know how well it can bridge. You gotta be careful the whole time. We just painted it an hour ago, and that's where we're at. Happy with your tape job, sweetheart?
Yeah, I was kind of worried for this area, but it's going good.
Got no red paint showing yet. No. That's good. That's fantastic. Silver looks really good. I like how that goes in there like that. And you also can be very critical of a car when it's not all put together. You know, you just see just looking at, you know, paint in one color, wheel covers. You get everything put back on it, get it outside, give it a couple washes, it'll look fine. I'm happy with the texture. The texture looks nice. I hate dirt. Dirt is, like I said, dirt is free. Now there'll be no polishing. This car, I wouldn't say. This is a one. This is urethane, so it's a one-step paint job. And I suppose you can polish it. Jim polished his car, but I wouldn't polish this car for a while. And the reason being is of the issues we had to start with. And the issues we had to start with was, you know, it's a plastic car. We don't really realize or know how well the paint's going to adhere. We epoxied this car first, and that was a good thing because it all covered nice today. Mm-hmm. It all covered nice. There's a bunch of putting back together on this car. And not looking forward to that part either. That's putting the moldings back on. And what I'm saying is the moldings that we have and the clips that we have, it's gonna be a hard one. Jolene is peeling the stuff off very slowly. And the reason being is because of the problems we had earlier. And we just don't want anything to come off. We get our fingers crossed. We got our toes crossed. Ugh. Well, that was successful. The front section is off, and that's how it looks. Well done. It looks good. Good tape job, Jolene. Jolene did a fantastic job taping it off. Fantastic. Mm-hmm. All right, let's go back to the quarter panel. Going back to the quarter panel, which side?
Okay, this side.
Okay, we're gonna go to this side. I'm gonna take the quarter panel off.
This one?
Right. No, down the bottom. We're gonna take that one off. Now this piece we never took off because it's kind of difficult to get off. And the paint is like we're right on the molding and right on the paint. This is where the paint can bridge across to your molding. That's where it can do that. And that's why we're doing what we're doing. It'd be harder to get off if it was completely dry. And I'm coming right up on you, Jolene. I'm coming up on you. See how you make it out. Good.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, you does. You look good. Ooh.
What?
It's Scary spot, that's all. I'm screaming for you.
Ooh.
Looks good.
Mm-hmm.
Beautiful. Awesome. Alrighty.
Where to next?
Let's go around the backside. We'll go around here. Jolene, we did the bumper very first thing. I got dove right in there and did that. Jolene said, let's film taking it off because people like to see that being taken off. That's what the silver looks like with the red. Trying to get down. Get down, Chad. Get down. Coming around this side. Showing you the nitty gritty. There's the silver on this side. It's got a nice contrast. Looks good. That now going the other way, go the other way with it. Do we have a little bit of peeling?
I think so.
Oh, yeah, we don't want to peel it that way because we peel it off the front. We go that way and go towards the back, right? See what happens. I'm nervous, and it's just a matter of. And the issue is you have to tape off the red to fix the silver. And we're not interested in taping any of the paint. Like, we're not interested, basically. We don't want to turn this into a back and forth. Oh, we got to do the silver. Then we got to do the red. Then we got to do back to the silver. No, we don't want to do that. We just like to get it pulled off and dealt with. Taking a look here for you. This is the red that we had in the shop. Jolene is going mega slow because we had a little issue at the end, I think. And that's not too bad. On something like this, if something happens here, I can put maybe a piece of cardboard, a piece of paper, a piece of Bristol board in front of it. And I can just go low, 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 low pressure and put a little silver paint if we have anything peeling there. Man, Jolie's doing a fantastic job. And the reason being I'm saying that is because she's going nice and slow. Alright, we got a little piece on the end that we're going to have to repair. You can see it right there. And it pulled off the paint, didn't it?
Yeah. So not even the primers.
So there's no primer there, so pull it off the paint again. We're gonna have to take a little bit of, we can even touch that up with a Q-tip or anything like that. I don't think we're gonna go, no, I'll touch that up before we even leave tonight. I'll touch it up with a Q-tip.
Mm-hmm.
And walking down the side of her. You can see on this door was the one that was kicked in. You can see the door is not kicked in on her no more. I put that molding, I put some, what is it called?
Foam.
Foam weather stripping, that's what it is, foam weather stripping. I put it and put it down the construction of the door, which held it out nice, and which did it all nice.
Last one, please.
Good tape job.
Mm-hmm, I was just gonna say that.
Would you?
Well, yeah, like.
Well, paint, eh?
Yeah. For how tricky it was.
Good tape job, actually. Very nice tape job. And that to that.
Mm.
There's the not the best, is it?
Mm.
We're just commending each other, have a good job. Sorry, not on the other. Probably not the red that you want either.
You like it. You when we're filming, but it's a lot more red up close.
You're asking for trouble there, aren't you?
Where?
Pull that off. I gotta get it, eh? Thank you.
Do you have a paintbrush anywhere?
Didn't we have like...
Jeez.
Didn't we have a bunch?
No, I'm talking about a little tiny one.
Oh.
So I can touch that up. Huh? Suggest?
Yeah.
Slowly.
Like just peel it down?
Yeah, there we go. What a bowl in the thread I am. Oh, you got those off.
Yeah.
Wow.
No, no,
wow.
That emblem should be trippy ricky.
Wow.
Because that was primed
on. I mean, I can think of a problem having that. Yeah.
That's
funny. And,
yeah.
Ooh. Phone number, eh? Mm-hmm. Ooh.
What? Got it?